Okay. I would like to talk today about the application of the Ultimate Debian database, as you had seen in the talk before me, in the Debian Poor Blends effort. Debian Poor Blends tries to harvest several information about packages for specific work fields, and I learned that UDD is really a cool tool to realize this. At first, I want to give a short introduction about Debian Poor Blends, what features we are using, which web tools we are using. Then I give a very short introduction into UDD because you have seen a long one and I just want to focus on the stuff I'm using. And finally, I want to talk a little bit about the future, what we want to implement for Debian Poor Blends and what we have to do. So for the short introduction of Debian Poor Blends, oops, I think. Formerly this effort was called Custom Debian Distributions, and this name was so frequently misunderstood that we decided to rename this effort. The problems were that the main understanding was CDD somehow sounded if it was something would be something else than Debian, but we always told people explicitly it's inside Debian because we are not strong enough to do something else than Debian, and so we had a big focus to make sure that we are inside Debian, and the former name just did not work. And so we just dropped the misleading names and found the name which is not optimal, but it forces you to read the docs what it actually is. And so if you Google for Debian Poor Blends or I've give some links, then you can read more about it, and I will explain it a little bit more in detail. The main point is that Debian Poor Blends, or in short also Blends, if I proceed in the talk, I will talk about Blends, is a subset of Debian that is configured to support a particular target group out of the box. So please remind the basic goals I always propagated for custom Debian distributions formerly and now for Blends. In Debian we have more than 22,000 packages, and it's a whole lot, and no user can install all on this machine, and there's no sense. And so the problem is how to pick the subsets you really want on your computer. The main focus of Blends is on some specialized users. So think of teachers in schools, or I come from the field of medicine, or if you are a scientific researcher, for instance, also in chemistry, you have also some focus of very specific applications. And you always are seeking for an easy way to install this application without doing much research. Imagine you would have to read all these 22,000 package description. You will at best understand 10% of this. I do not understand everything myself, so it would be a nightmare if you want to do it. And so we try to make a focus on this specific application, while Debian stays general and at the universal operating system, we want to provide support for specialists. So I mention it once more, it is no derivative from Debian, it is just the basic idea is to make not a separate distribution, but make Debian fit to provide support for special purpose, for all these purposes where people take the work and have do the effort to work on such a custom Debian distribution. There could be much more than currently are existing, but I hope that the idea to support these special applications would a little bit more penetrate. Moreover, I want to stretch a little bit the connection we as a Debian developer are building between upstream developers and users. Especially if you have some specific applications which are not used by a big user group. So we have packages with low popcorn values. The upstream needs really support to get his software published. And so we try as a Debian developer tie a network between upstream developers and users, because the upstream developers are those specialists who are our target group as well. The Rechenelle is expert in this field. He need help to package their software. I have very frequently observed that they provide Tarbas with not so optimal build system, don't use auto build, automake or this stuff. And so they are really, really happy if they get the support of skilled developers who know how to install programs properly and make a solid installation system or build system. And so they are really happy if we as Debian developers look at their code. So upstream anticipate this enhancement of their build system and also a security audit. And finally, the upstream developers also support Debian because they learn if we support them that they could also bring their software to more people. And so they are really happy and support us as a maintainers. And in my opinion, it would be a nice thing if we get more upstream developers to become even Debian developers. So do I want to attract people for the Debian Pure Blends effort? On one hand, I would like to get some more Debian developers involved in this effort. And my idea is if we provide some interesting techniques, which I will show you later, then people are convinced. Debian developers are technic freaks and want to have catchy things, and so I hope the connection to UDD is a nice way to go. I learned that several Debian developers are interested to categorize their packages. There are things like deb tags, and we are using it in a UDD effort with so-called task files, which enable an easy classification in which category your package fits, and you can define some dependencies to group package to certain work tasks. And that's why it's called task files. We are not competing with deb tags. Actually, we rather try to merge the deb tags and task files stuff. I have not made up my mind how to do it really, but we want to work together. So we try to provide some key documentation feature in the form of the task page I will show you later. And we also have some so-called bugs pages, which makes a good QA measure, because if a developer looks at the bugs pages where all the bugs according to a certain work field related packages are listed, then you can easily pick those bugs you are really interested in, that these packages are okay, or you work with these packages, and so you have a good overview. I also plan to include the DEHS system, which means it is a Debian external health system where the watch files are seek to find out if the Debian package is the current version, like upstream, or if we are lagging behind. And so these pages will follow soon after DevConf, and I hope this will be also very useful tool. On the other hand, we want to attract users. That's why I have a strong focus to internationalize the web pages to display the relevant packages. This is basically a thing. If people ask me, what are you doing? I'm running this Debian Meet project, and they ask me, what actually is Debian Meet? Then I can lead them to these task pages and then see we have some certain task. It is a practice management, it is digital imaging, or this is biology, and they can see, oh, all this stuff is inside Debian, and you can view them with one view in their language, as long as this is translated, what we are doing. And this is an important point, because if you are talking about specialists, for instance, specialists here in Spain, they are not necessarily able to speak English fluently enough to understand all these descriptions. And so this package, these task pages really help to make people understand what actually is inside Debian. So we try to provide a complete working environment for these people. We didn't succeed in every field. We succeeded, for instance, in Debian Edu efforts quite good. This is a system which is implemented also in some variation here in Extremadura in the schools, but other plans are lagging behind Debian Edu for certain reasons. We can come back later if you are interested. And finally, we want to raise the interest of users to have ready to install software. Quite frequently, you have some software lists in the internet. So in principle, we provide some lists of software ABC, and there are many, many lists I know for biology also, but none of these lists provides ready-to-install software. And this is a good thing in Debian because you can fire up, for instance, Synaptic and just install the software and test it, which makes a huge effort if you have just a linked list to home pages. So, in principle, a specified user looks at Debian like this and has no idea what packages are inside, and we, as a Debian Blends effort, try to make this focus specific applications. This, in my opinion, this graph says actually what the Blend is doing, focusing the interest of the user to specific work fields. And there should be more of these lenses to make sure that more people or more specific fields will be attracted by Debian. So what actual features we have in the Blends effort? Basically, we define a set of dependency relations. So if you have a certain task, say medical imaging, and we have about 20 packages in Debian which are doing or which are serving for this task, then we say depends and add a list of these packages. This, in the toolset, the dependencies are verified. In case they are not available, package just will be added as a suggests. If I install the meta package, which results out of this dependency, you get, for instance, the meta package medical imaging. Then you get for packages which are lacking only a suggests, because we have not these packages in main, Debian main. It might be in runfree or it might be in any other mirror which is not specified, but in this way we make sure that the list of dependencies will be really certified. This way we create from this task file which specifies the dependency a control file to build valid meta packages. And also we built a task cell input file which can be used with the task cell tool. Then we have some web tools which provide information about these packages of interest which are in this actual meta package. And the task files are read straight out the SVN of the Blend. So it is the web tool is more up to date than the meta package, because the meta package will be updated only from time to time if there is some request or some need for it. So it shows the dependency relations of packages inside Debian, and it also shows some additional information, because if there is an interesting package we would like to have in Debian, then we can add this information to the task file, and for instance the NPP bug, to get some kind of a to-do list and see what we are working on. I will demonstrate shortly. So we try on this web page to gather all the information about the packages which are defined as dependency in the task file. The intention of the task pages is to be a key entry point for the user and to give a very quick overview what's actually done in the task which is dealt in the blend. We have also a first slide connection to DevTags in the task pages, and when I built these task pages, I just learned that it is a really good QA tool to make sure that the descriptions are okay and the homepage tag is really good set or really correctly set. And so I will try to demonstrate a little bit of these pages. Here you see the result of such a task page. I mentioned the medical imaging page, and the colors are not very good. This color is basically green. It is not very different on this projector from yellow, you will see below. What can you see here? You see that medical imaging is depending from the package Esculap, which is a medical image viewer. You have the home page. You know who maintains the package. You know how many users are using this. It is about 23 users. It is derived from the Popcorn data. You have an overview which versions are in which release in Debian. You can also see the dev tags which are tagged for the package. And here you can even see a screenshot of this package. This is more or less the optimal situation because we have not so many screenshots for all the application inside Debian. So if you feel you would like to support not only these task pages but everything else, you can go and take some screenshots and make this better and Debian also better. The task page, if you have a certain interest or certain world field, just go the according task page. You can ask me if you don't find it. And here is a link how to upload a screenshot. Here is directly a link. So if the screenshot is missing, you can go and try to make a good screenshot and upload it and to make this better. And as well, you can also provide some dev tags here in this case of the next program, which is called Carrot. These dev tags are missing. So then we have some packages which are in the new queue. So that means the package is ready from developer and you are waiting now what's here. And so this is a yellow section. I told you this is green here, and here we go to yellow. We expect Slicer to be in a short time to be inside Debian and can be used. Then we also have a section where some external people build Debian packages, where some development has been done. This information has to be provided in the task files explicitly because we can't draw it from any information source inside Debian. And finally, we have this red section. This is in the, yeah, this should be red here. It's supposed to be red. Here we just provide some information about what we want to do. There is a bug filed, this VNPP bug, where we say, well, we are working on this and you can provide some information to inform the user that there's some work going on, and we can ask for help, or he can try to work on the packaging, and so we try to involve users in our effort to make it better. Some other examples here for this is from Debian Edu Chemistry. Here you have also the screenshot, and well, okay, I just noticed that it's not really translated. I try to change the language, and then you can see all well, it makes no sense to change the language here. I just will scroll down, and you can explicitly ask for instance Espanol, and you see here is Spanish translation in case it is provided. In this case, in the next case, it is not provided. And if I make the screen a little bit slower, this is not optimized for this size. You can, well, it will not be shown here. No idea why. Oh, here. Here you can say translate description. There is a link. So if you see that there is a description missing for the package and you are native speaker of Spanish, then you can click on this link and you go directly to the DDTP server and you can provide a translation and it will show up later. So your fellow co-workers who are working in the same field will have a profit and understand the description. Or if you realize the description is not really correct, you would like to correct it, there's also a link you can fix the translated description. So this hopefully makes clear we want to involve the users with this task page, and we try to involve the users who are working in this specific field. These are the main features of the task pages, as I wanted to show here in the more dry way of explaining things, but I hope the demonstration makes things more clear. So the next thing is more developer related. I try to find some measure to how we can make sure that the packages we are providing to the users are in a good quality. And so I try to find a way to display how the bugs are of all the dependent packages of a meta package. And currently we have the problem that the bug statistic looks from the first view quite bad, because if you have a meta package which depends from a lot of applications, then they gather some bugs, and mostly they are colored terribly red. And but I didn't do the normalization to the number of meta packages, because I think if there's a bug, it should be fixed. And so I do not want to get bugs lost because there are many dependencies. I'm not really sure if this is a good idea. So I tried to find some rating numbers for different severities, ranging from 10 for release critical bugs to 0 for wishlist bugs. I do not think that we don't should fix wishlist bugs, but normally if a package has any bugs, you go to the page and see the wishlist bugs and then you can fix them. So for instance, if you have one serious bug in any dependent package of a meta package, you get one bug which is serious, which gets a factor 10, and because it's a dependent package, we multiply with dry, and so you get a write of 30 for this bug. Then you have, for instance, two important bugs in a dependent package. Two bugs in the dependent is two important bugs makes 5, and dependent package multiplied by 3, because the dependent packages are more important for us than the only suggested packages. So the suggested packages get only the one as a factor, so one important bug with a 5, only factor 1 with this. Then we have, for instance, one normal bug in a dependent package with 3, and we have here 9. And if there is a minor bug, it gets a value of 1, 1, 3. And if you sum this up, you get so-called weighted sum of 77. So this number is not the number of bugs, but the weight I try to evaluate for a meta package. How it looks in reality. If you go to the bugs page, for instance, of Debian Science, you see here is a red colored, let's look in astronomy, for instance. The Debian Science astronomy package, meta package, depends from a certain amount of applications, and you see you have here one red colored bug which is release critical, and that's why red. And you have certain important bugs, they are yellow, and the green bugs are normal. And so you see you have some a certain number of bugs, and this sums up to 91 total bugs, 74 are open and 17 are fixed. And here you have the number of critical, grave, serious bugs. And all these numbers result in a weight of 4, 6, 8. I just discussed it in the Debian Science book. We have to make sure that this weight is a little bit better. What you currently see, you have a quite quick overview which package is buggy and where are the most problems. So according to this weight, I tried to make some kind of evaluation. So the idea was a meta package cannot be of the status good if there is at least one serious or higher bug in a dependent package. That means if there is one serious bug in dependent, gets a 30, and so it can't be good because good means lower than 30. Or a package cannot be very good if there is one RC bug in also in a suggested package. So these are quite strong rules and we have to adapt it a little bit. But I hope you get the idea. I try to find a way to attract users to problematic meta package, or better, the meta package is not problematic, but the dependencies of the meta package are problematic, and I try to catch the users or the developers to fix these bugs. So now we come to UDD. As a short introduction, we have seen in the last talk, these are the tables we are having in UDD. It is a PostgreSQL database which tries to provide information. You have seen more or less the same slide from Lucas. I'm very, very happy with this DEHS because this really helps us to make another new page, which is very important for us to make sure we provide up-to-date packages. It will be, I intend to make it quite similar to the bugs page, and I hope to provide this soon. The information is updated via cron jobs from different public sources, and for the sake of Debian Problems, I just added the translations from the Debian Description Translation Project. This is what I showed you with the internationalization when I switched to the Spanish page. This is a very interesting effort, and I can't repeat it enough. Try to provide package translation to enable your fellow coworkers in your language to learn about Debian packages. I also added the screenshots data, which are missing on this slide, and I also added the news data because I use it as well. And finally, we have some Ubuntu information in the UDD package, which is currently not that interesting, except for the bugs which are in Ubuntu Launchpad. I intend to add these also to the bugs overview because I think if we know that there is a bug according to a certain software, we should not really hide this information. I have no real idea how to display it, but I think it's a valuable information we should not hide on this page. The features of UDD are easy to write gatherers for new information sources. Well, I have to admit, I was quite new to UDD and it was not really hard. I used some examples which from other gatherers, and then I was quite easy to able to write new ones. It is, you need a little bit of Python skills and yeah, some copy and paste from the other, and you are basically done. So, I added this DDDP, new queue, and screenshots gatherers, which were actually in UDD because I wanted to build these pages. And I like also the possibility to compare Debian version numbers. You know, they are a little bit hard. It's not a simple string comparison because you can have certain additional characters inside which do not fit to a string comparison, and this is very, very helpful to get the right version out of the database. And UDD just contains all relevant information about packages we are needing for blends, and so it's the ideal tool. And since I'm using UDD about 4 or 5 months the speed, how can I add new features to the spend stuff, increase drastically. It is, it's amazing. So what are the advantages of using UDD for blends? Formerly, I built these task pages by just parsing packages GZ files, and for the sake of performance, and well, I could perfectly parse all the packages GZ file for all architectures and for all releases, but it make no sense for this purpose. And so task pages were not always really correct, basically correct, but not always. And now I get it very easy to meet with just one select statement, and they are correct. I had also to do a large effort to download all the DDTP translations from the original source. And now, after I injected them in UDD, I get them very quickly with one select statement, and this is really easy, and it's just fun to use UDD. And also when I built the bugs pages, the BTS has some SORP interface, which is okay, it works, but on my machine it took so much time, and with the select on UDD it's just faster, and you have a consistent interface, you just gather all the information from UDD, and this is really cool. So we have all information in one place. This is a very important thing, because you have easy access to the information you need, and as I said, it is very easy to add new information. You get the information about all releases, which was not possible formerly. You get all available versions, all architectures, and even experimental was excluded formerly for, yeah, because it was not so important, but now you get it just for free. The DDTP injection helps a lot, and the BTS information you get with this quick select. What are the new features? For UDD, I added these features for the Debian Blends effort, and the task pages got the popcorn results, what were formerly not included, because it would be very hard to gather information from a new source. And also DebTags. DebTags also came for no effort at all. We have also the VCS usage, because it's interesting. If you see there is a bug in a package and you know where the BTS, where the package source is in BTS, you have easy access and just are informed about the things. And this is also very easy to get. And we got the information about the new queue, because some packages are just hanging around in the new queue for a while, and we want to inform our users the package is, well, nearly there, hopefully nearly there. And screenshots Debian.net is also a really cool effort. If you find some time in DebConf, I'm considering sending announcements to DebConf announce, please everybody fire up one application of your choice and provide a screenshot every day. And if all the 250 people would do every day, I think we could make a really good success in screenshotting Debian. I don't know if any other distribution has this feature, and like it's really cool, because if you connect it to Synaptic and a new user want to install a program and just see the screenshot, I think it would be amazing. So what are the blend features for Debian Blends? So I told you I want to make more QA overviews, and DEHS feature is there in UDD, and so no effort anymore. I also want to give a Lintian overview to make sure that packages have a really good quality we are using in the blend. I also wanted to add the Ubuntu bugs to make sure that no information is hidden. I have no idea how we can make sure that there are no duplicates between Debian and Ubuntu. Perhaps Don might know an answer also. Furthermore, I want to base blend dev, which is used to build a meta package which you finally can install, use UDD. We have the problem That currently we build meta package with architecture all because the current meta package build system has the same problem as we had I had in the task pages. We just look into one architecture packages file to find out which dependencies are resolved inside Debian. But this is not correct because there might be some dependencies which are not available for all architectures. So we shouldn't build architecture all, but architecture any meta package, and this can be solved easily if I would port the BlendStef tools to UDD. And I will do so in perhaps, I hope to do it in fall. Then I'm thinking about including the information which is stored in the task file also into UDD. Then currently the task file is read from the SVN, which works somehow, but if it would be also injected from SVN, perhaps with a upload script that is automatically synced to UDD or whatever I will use, then I could stick completely inside the UDD universe, which might make some sense. I haven't made up my mind completely, but this might be a thing I might do. Yeah, what's to do? So, as I said, we have to do further enhancement. I will rewrite the BlendStef stuff to use UDD. And I would like to make even more projects to use this blend stuff. The Debichem project, which is basically doing a framework for chemistries, is a very good candidate to be a full pure blend. I'm in contact with Michael Bank, and I hope we finish it here in the on at DebConf. The same with Debian GIS. And missing on this frame is the Brazilian desktop project. We want also to apply all this framework. Some start is done, and I think this will take not so much time to implement for the Brazilian desktop. These techniques I explained, and I will work together with Thiago Thun, and perhaps it will be also happen at DebConf. Yeah, and then I also try to bring back some external projects. This is, as I explained in the beginning, the custom Debian distribution were also considered as external efforts. And so some people just took Debian and turned it a little bit into some more, for instance, for audio recording or so. And so they build a new distribution from Debian, which is perfectly okay from the license. But we think it's much more effort if you try to make some clones or forks from Debian. So I want to try to convince these people to look at the nice tools we have, or I think they are nice and helpful. And if they are interesting for them, they might be interested to merge back to Debian so that we get a Debian audio project or whatever. I was in contact with some people, and I hope to revitalize this to get some more blends inside Debian and finally more strengthen Debian on other fields. So that's all. Thanks for your attention. My talk is online. It is not yet linked, but I will do it this evening, so you can download it from there. And you can tell any questions. There's a mailing list where you can join if you are interested. And I would be happy if you are interested. Thank you. Any questions?
Hey. In the BR desktop, that's a Brazilian blend, we receive a lot of feedback from users that by mailing list that wants to remove some packages and add in other packages, and sometimes they started to fight in the list for choosing such audio player. Etc. And I was thinking I'm working in a specific PopCon server for BR desktop, because for us it's important to have a real feedback about which packages users from BR desktop are removing and are installing. Mm-hmm. And I think the PopCon from Debian, you cannot get this information. Can you imagine some way to integrate, from which meta package that package was installed, something like? Do you think is it important?
I think I have two answers. At first, I think we could, Luca, you might correct me, we could probably include also your PopCon data into UDD to make it at least visible. As well as Ubuntu packages import, you can be our desktop PopCon tables, and then it's at least there. The second question, I have no idea whether you can have a connection between a meta package and a package which is installed on behalf of this meta package, because we have no real trace. You can install the dependent package manually before the meta package, then you can install the meta package which has no influence on this package because it's there, and you can even remove the meta package and the package remains, because we turn all the depends into recommends. The rationale behind this is that the Debian Edu people learned that if you have hard dependencies from a meta package, you are not flexible enough anymore. And so we decided to use only recommends, which is fine because apt-get installs them by default, so you have to force your installer to not to install recommends. I'm thinking about making the task file more explicit, that we use real recommends in a task file, and if we mean it depends, then should be the pens safe, but that's not implemented. But I see no means to have a relation to PopCon.
Yeah, the thing is we need to know which packages BR desktop users are removing and are installing. That's important for us. Yeah. And I trying to imagine some kind of integration with maybe a alternative PopCon for Blends that I don't know.
Yeah, you mean that we in general implement PopCon BR desktop, PopCon Meet, PopCon Edu,
yeah,
or what?
That's I'm working now, okay. But I don't know if it's a good solution. Mm. Because actually we try to release Debian testing release, BR desktop and testing stable release, and we need to select new packages, and that's good to know which one are most used to release to the next release.
Yeah. Yeah, the problem is perhaps you have a hard time to know who is actually a Blends user. Is the Blends user a user who installed one specific meta package, or is it not? Or is a Blends user one who installed Meet physics and science physics? They both exist. They have a little different dependencies. So is this user belonging to the Debian Meet or Debian science? This is a little bit difficult to know how to decide who is a Blends user. It might be a different case in BR desktop, because you are providing install media. And if you have an install media, you can set some flex somewhere. Or Debian Edu also provides install media. In principle, it is planned for every Blend to have install media, but we are not so much advanced that we have generalized tools to to create this media. So if this is a definition, install medium, then we could most probably have a specific PopCon data.
I was going to say, just on that last point, surely all you need to do is obtain from the guys who've got the data
if people who've the PopCon data from people who have installed the Brazilian desktop, I mean, how to ask them is a slightly different question. But if you've the information surely is in the PopCon database for who has Brazilian desktop, the Brazilian desktop package installed, and who has everything else installed. So it's just a question of performing the right database query, I would think.
No, I think that the difference is Brazilian desktop and Debian Edu provides install media, dedicated install media with pre-configured DevConf question and so. And in my opinion, this is a key point if you want to have a specific PopCon data. Then you have to set some PopCon flag, whatever, to flag this as a specific blend user. Any other question?
On a more generic note, as you showed in your slides, the blends basically focus the attention of both users and developers on a specific functionality. Have you considered more generic blends like Debian desktop blend or Debian server blend?
Yeah, it's just a question who does the work. That's simple. There is a Debian desktop effort which started in the, if you read the old documentation as a CDD or blend, and Debian server might be Debian Enterprise. There is a Debian Enterprise list. It's very funny. I did this list statistics. You can perhaps I did something like this. If you go to any of these blends lists, you get this list statistic who is active in a blend. And so this is, for instance, an accessibility list. Then you can see in the mailing list the active poster over all the time was Samuel Thibault. It's a French developer who is. Started development in 2004 and became even more active. This year is not finished, so it's not relevant. And second most active developer is Mario Lang. He's also at DevConf here. And I made also this graph for the Debian Enterprise list. And there, last year there was even two spammers who made the most active posters of this list. So yeah, it's just because there is a need, there's a big need, and I would really love if some people would take the effort and make an enterprise blend. And I see some very interesting tasks in this, but actually there's nobody doing the work. And so, yeah, as always, if you find somebody who's interested, just go on.
On the question of install media, just before the last release, I had a little bit of time and tried to get a live image, a science live image produced. And I mean, I think I ran out of time. And but in fact, it looked like it was incredibly easy for the live image guys to say, hey, you've got a meta package. All we need to do is install all the packages on that meta package. So for science specifically, I think it was about 2.5 gigabytes. Ended up on the installed it on a DVD, and that's something that potentially is interesting to people. It's something that I can put a little bit of effort into, but don't have time to spend an enormous amount of effort on. But it's just looked so simple to do.
Yeah, this is completely right. It's also mentioned in the blend docs. I would like to make some. One line or one click method to build a live DVD of all the meta package dependencies, but well, somebody has to do it. I was not able to finish this, and though I didn't talk about this here, yeah, if somebody wants to do it, you're very welcome, and it's definitely a nice thing. Okay, so I will leave this space for the next speaker. No more questions, you can come back to me every time. Thank you for your attendance.